friends, it's Isabella. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I hope you enjoy your stay. Today we're going to be doing something that's been very highly requested from me. If you've seen a couple of my vlogs, then you know that I love to annotate my books. So this video is going to be all about my annotation process, why I annotate, how I annotate, the materials I use, just basically everything that has to do with annotation and my process I'm going to be talking about. I also asked you guys if you had any questions for me, and we're going to be doing a quick little Q&A at the very end. So first and foremost, what is annotating? What is annotating? Let's look it up. Webster Dictionary, annotating. Annotating is any action that deliberately interacts with a text to enhance the reader's understanding of and reaction to the text. Sometimes called close reading, annotating usually involves highlighting or underlining key pieces of text and making notes in the margins of the text. There we go, that came right out of the top of my head. It's like, if you see a book and it has tabs like this, it probably has either highlighter or annotated lines, it has text on the margins or throughout the text. I mean, annotating can be different for everybody. This is just my own personal process. I used to be one of those people that were like, I can never write in my books. My books are sacred. I can't damage them. I can't ruin them. And I started my annotating journey very slowly. I started just like using the tabs. I didn't underline anything. I just put the tab on the place that I liked. And then I started using post-its because I didn't want to write directly on the paper. And then one day I just went for it. I was like, I love this quote so much. I need to underline it. I need to talk about it. And it's also a way for me to feel closer to the book. It becomes so much more than a simple book when you annotate in it. And I feel like with every annotation, you're leaving a little bit of yourself in that book. It becomes this time machine because when I've reread some old annotated copies of my own, they say a lot about the person that I was when I was reading that book. So whenever I go back through my annotations, it's always so wonderful to see my character development. It enhances 100% your reading experience, whether it helps you understand the text more or whether it brings you closer to the book and the characters. It's just beautiful. I love it. I know that not everybody feels the same way that I do. I know that some people still think the same way that I did before I started, which was that annotating ruins a book, that in school my teachers taught me that you should never write in a book. And that is true if the book doesn't belong to you, if you've paid money for it, and if you feel comfortable, and if it's from your own library, why not do whatever you want to do with it? You know what I mean? Like, that's just my opinion. You're fine to think otherwise. You're fine to think incorrectly. So this is my annotation pouch. This came in an Illumicrate box, I believe. Yes, Illumicrate. And it's very wide. So it fits a lot of my materials. First and foremost, you know, the one thing that can never be missing from, where is it? It's the sticky tabs. Come on now, like these, bread and butter. Yes, they're the basic of every single annotation pouch. For me, every color does have a meaning, so I will get into that after we go through all of my materials, but these are the tabs that I use. I'm going to be leaving a link down below if you're interested. I have two pens that I like to use for writing in the margins. So I have the colored ones to underline, and then I have these pens so that I can write down any thoughts that I have. This one is the Uniball Micro 207. So I really like it when my pens have like a thin point, because otherwise I feel like the text is really big. And then this one is probably my new favorite one. It's the Pilot G205. This is stunning. It writes so smoothly and so soft. It's like writing on a cloud, basically. Of course, I have a little ruler because when I underline, I like my lines to be straight. I'm sorry. I know some people just go for it and they don't really care about the crookedness, which is fine. That's totally amazing. I love that for you. But for me personally, I love a straight line. These are the Staedtler Tripless Fine Liners. And for my color coding, I like to match the colors to their respective tabs. So if I'm going to be using the pink, I'm going to underline in pink. If I'm going to use the blue, I'm going to use the blue. I actually really recommend these because I've tried different underliners and I feel like a lot of them bleed through the pages. Like, no matter how thick the page of the book is, they just always bleed through. And even though these do have a little of bleed through, especially when the pages are like extremely thin, I feel like from all of the underliners that I've tried, these have the least amount of bleed through. So if that's something that's worrisome for you, definitely try these. This is new for me, and it's actually, I've loved incorporating this into my annotation process. It's highlighters. Come on now. Yes, these are revolutionary. These have started a new era in my annotation journey. I love highlighters. These specifically are the Stabilo Boss pastel ones, I guess. Stabilo Boss original pastels. And they are stunning. They are beautiful. Sometimes I can't be bothered with the ruler and the underlining, so I just go on, whip one of these bad boys out, and I go ham on the highlighting. And honestly, it looks really good. It looks stunning. I mean, I do love me an underlined moment, but I mean, come on. Okay, this is a little bit intense, and I'm going to get into the why, but look at this, looks gorgeous. In my opinion, I'm obsessed. What makes me choose between underlining and highlighting? I couldn't tell you. There's really no science behind it. It's just me being like, this is a highlight moment, or this is an underlining moment. Let's move on to my color coding and what each color means. Pink means favorite quotes or lines that I really like, or especially in books where the writing is very lyrical and very beautiful, I like to underline certain passages that I'm just like, that was stunning, let's go back to that. The orange is for funny moments. The yellow one is for important plot information, especially in fantasy books. I find myself using this a lot because, of course, it's a fantasy world. There's new rules, there's magic systems, there's like people with different powers, and I use the yellow whenever there's like important information. I used to use green for moments that made me angry, but then I realized I never want to go back to moments that made me angry, so why would I annotate this? So recently I've been using green for, how do I explain this? It's like, it's when I want to analyze a certain part of the text, or if there's some historical context related to that phrase. Or for example, recently in a book that I was reading, there was this Greek mythology that was mentioned, and I wasn't exactly 100% sure of what this Greek mythology meant or what it symbolized. So I looked it up and I wrote down in the margins what it was talking about. I'm gonna give you an example because I feel like I did so badly trying to explain that. This is the picture of Dorian Gray, Hi, by Oscar Wilde. And as you can see, there are a couple of green tabs. If we open up a random green tab here, I underlined, I had drawn you as Paris in dainty armor and as Adonis with huntsman's cloak and polished boar spear. So in the post-it, I write about Paris and Adonis. It's just like a way to fully immerse myself in the text and make sure that I understand what the author was trying to talk about or what he was trying to symbolize. So green is very much that. It's just like further research or further investigation into some symbols or some elements that the author decided to put into the text. I feel like that was so complicated. I hope, if you have any questions about that, I can definitely go more in depth, but I think I'm gonna leave it there. Blue is for sad moments, moments that made me cry, moments that made me go bald, moments that had my hairline receding, just like overall moments that made me die. So I do have two purple ones. One is like a lighter purple and this one is a lot darker. Once I use them, the difference in color is very minimal, so I don't feel like giving them a different meaning, and also I don't really need another color, so The two purples I use for favorite moments, or like when a whole scene is my favorite, I annotate it with a purple tab. Something that I've recently started doing is that every 50 pages or every 100 pages, I write a post-it of just in general what's been going on in the story. This is very useful, especially with fantasy books, because of course there's a lot of information, there are a lot of events, and it can be every 50 pages or every 100 pages, it depends how much is going on, but it's also a way of seeing how you're feeling throughout the book, because apart from the information that you're writing about what's going on, you can also write about your emotions and how you're liking the book so far. So you can really think about how you're liking the book and if you're vibing with it or not. So I feel like it's a great way to just connect with the story and just make sure that you're really understanding what's going on. The post-its that I used for Dorian Gray, they're not really for plot summary. It's more like if I have a very elaborate or if I have a very long thought or emotion or an idea that I want to talk about, I used post-its for that because Dorian Gray, if you can't tell, is one of my all-time favorite classics. So when I annotated this, I had so many things to talk about. I had so many things to discuss. So there are a lot of post-its throughout the book, just me going off on Lord Henry, me going off on Dorian. It's amazing. Let's move on to the questions. So the first one is, do you have a separate notebook you use too if you have a longer thought? I do not. I just use the post-its, and if I have too many thoughts, I just try to be as concise and as precise as possible, because if I have a separate notebook, I just feel like it's not as good, you know, because using the post-its, the thought and the emotion is right there in the book. I don't need to go to a separate place and try to connect. You know what I mean? Like, it's all in one book, and that's kind of how I like it. How to face the I'm a stupid idiot, who cares what I think fears. Sis, are you okay? First of all, you're not a stupid idiot. I'm sorry. Like, you're really not. I don't know you personally, but I know that you're not a stupid idiot. I feel like stupid idiots don't ask themselves if they're a stupid idiot. I don't think I've ever had this thought because when I annotate for myself. I'm not annotating to impress anybody else or to make anybody think that I'm interesting or fun or like an intellectual. I have fun with my annotations. Sometimes they can be really deep and very insightful. Other times they're just like, oh my god, or I'm bald, or I'm sobbing, or I can't take this, or somebody give me a sedative. Like, annotating books shouldn't feel like a chore. You shouldn't pressure yourself into sounding smart or insightful. You just have fun with it. It doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. Just go and have fun with it. Make it your own. Have you ever annotated something and then later in the book regretted because of how that event turned out? I used to annotate every single book that I read. Like, right from page one, I would already be writing. And then I read The Archived by Victoria Schwab. Probably one of the worst books I've read, probably one of the most boring. I wish I could unhaul this, but I cannot because I annotated it. I underlined it with red because there was a lot of information dumping. So this has my annotations, and unfortunately, I hated this book. I think I gave it like 2 stars, which is being very generous, if you ask me. And now, it's just a feeling that I get with every book. I give it around 100 pages to see if I want to annotate, but if before that time, or just in general, if I never get the feeling of I really want to annotate this book, then I use post-its. This is a good example. This is XOXO by Axie O. I didn't get that immediate feeling of I want to annotate the heck out of this book, so I used post-its. Instead of writing directly on the book or underlining, I just used tabs and I used post-its because I didn't want to write in the book in case after I finished it, I didn't want to keep it. I could just very easily rip off the post-it, take off the tab, no harm done. That's the lesson that I learned with the archived. What are your favorite kind of books to annotate? I would say classics. I have so much fun annotating classics. I mean, I keep coming back to Picture of Dorian Gray. I have so much fun dissecting the text and analyzing it and seeing the impact of it in society and like breaking down a few lines. It's so fun to annotate classics because there's so much material. It's just such a wonderful and such a rich world. Do you ever get bogged down by annotating? Like you feel obligated to and reading just takes forever? Obviously, sometimes I can't be bothered to take out my ruler or take out my highlighter and just like underline when I just kind of want to read, I kind of just want to speed through it. So whenever that happens, here we have my copy of Tokyo Ever After. I do use tabs, but that's it. I don't take the time to annotate. I don't take the time to write anything down. If something is funny, I just kind of tab it. If something is memorable, I just tab it. But especially this book, I read this while I was traveling, so of course I couldn't really take out my annotation pouch, sit down and like underline because I was always on the move. So I just took my tabs with me, I used it as a bookmark, and whenever something good happened, I just tabbed it because I couldn't be bothered. I mean, just in general, if you ever feel bogged down by annotating, just don't do it. Like, nobody's forcing you to do it. Annotating shouldn't feel like a chore. You're not doing this for college. You're not doing this for high school. You're doing this for yourself. So, like, don't stress. How often do you tab? Do you tab everything or only tab your absolute favorite things? I don't really, like, catch myself counting how many times I tab. It's just, like, moments that I really connect with or certain lines that I really love or things that I don't want to forget. Or moments that I know that I would love to go back to, I feel like those are really good ones to tab. Can you annotate? Okay, no, I'm not reading that. That is not safe for work. Chelsea, DMs. This isn't about the process, but what if you want to get rid of the book? So, of course, the archived, I couldn't get rid of it. F in chat for respects, but I usually have friends that don't mind my annotations and they actually find it very endearing and like a glimpse into my life. So I usually give it to friends if they're interested in the book. Could you suggest highlighters that don't bleed through even in books which have thin pages? I mean, if somebody knows of any highlighters that don't bleed through even in thin pages, please let me know because I know that the Stabilo ones, they're really good, but they do have a little bit of bleed through. I personally don't mind them because it's not really bad. But yeah, thin pages are not highlighter's best friend. How do you manage not to smudge the ink of your pen in your books? Well, the pens that I use, they're really good at not doing that, so I don't even have to worry about that. So maybe get the pens that I use. I want to annotate, but I can't get myself to. Please give some tips to start annotating. Why don't you start with just tabbing? Get yourself one of these packages and just start annotating some favorite moments that you have in the book or things that you would like to go back to after you finish the book. I feel like if you start slowly instead of just fully going head in and trying to do everything that I or other people do, you're going to get a bit overwhelmed. So it's always good to start baby steps, literally baby steps. The more that you get comfortable with it, the more exciting it's going to be to try and do different things. So I think that's like my number one tip. Just don't rush into things. Just take it step by step. How do you manage to be so funny in your annotations? Astrid, hi. I'm just funny like that. It comes naturally. I don't even have to try. I'm just funny. Why do you make little summaries? Isn't that burdensome to do? I mean, it could be for some people, but I personally don't find them burdensome. I find them very helpful, and they also help me focus in on the story. When there's a lot of things going on, doing those little summaries after a certain amount of pages is really good to keep yourself inside of the story and make sure that you're not missing any important information. Don't you feel like reading becomes a task when you annotate instead of something fun? Annotating is fun, so if I ever feel like it's becoming a task, I just stop and I just like, I just read the book and forget about annotating. You don't have to annotate every single book that you read. If it doesn't feel right, if it doesn't feel like something that you want to do with that book, you are in every right to just stop annotating and just be like, I just want to read. Like, that's completely fine as well. I think that's going to be it for this annotation video. I hope you guys found a few new tips and tricks or got inspired to start annotating your own books. Let me know if you have any questions down below. I'll do my very best to answer each and every one of them. At the end of the day, annotating books is a very personal experience. It's a very personal journey, and it's been wonderful. Annotating has elevated my reading to astronomical levels. I feel like I understand the book so much more, and I feel like the reading experience is just enhanced because I feel so connected to the story and the characters and the writing, and I just feel like I understand it so much better when I annotate. Of course, that's not the case for everybody, but it is for me, so that's what I'm sharing. I hope you had fun, I hope you enjoyed, and yeah, I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!
Hey Jimmy, you nice, keep going.